subject that I don't really enjoy teaching puppies to do. Puppies are usually all over the place. Anything that involves sitting still and not moving usually goes against the grain. So the little Bettie will be demonstrating how you can teach a little puppy a little composition and a focus and what they call controlled relaxation. Right, the food has been measured. There's a bit of a wet food waiting to be added. She's on a mix of dry and wet. And we will be introducing a very interesting skill such as freeze or staying still. To start with, and Bettie has done it before, all I've been doing was raising the hand and rewarding the puppy for not reacting to it. So we've done quite a lot of that. As you can see, each one of those only takes about a split second, and Bettie is comfortably ignoring the hand, the touch, the sort of grasp right there. Now, one thing one must remember when teaching exercises of this sort, this is what we call a choice training. So anything you do, you have to give the dog a way out of it. If at any point she feels uncomfortable with it or just wants to pull back, I would offer her that chance. Right, so to start with, I will try to touch and sort of grab the parts of the body which are not as sensitive, meaning that we leave the face and anything around it pretty much for the end. So body, release, reward. So we go in the exact same sequence, touch, release, reward. Just moving the hands around the body into different positions, teaching Bettie to tolerate those. It's okay to be touching several places at once, it's okay to be moving the fingers there, but as you can see, I never apply any pressure, just teaching the puppy to fall asleep, if you like, or freeze when my hand's there. I have applied the words to it, so saying still means Bettie knows what to anticipate, so she's expecting me to go and brush with my hands all over her body. Right, so now we have done hundreds and hundreds of those repetitions, and as you can see, with tiny little biscuits such as those, you can go at a very high pace, just like me, talking and rewarding Bettie for every little contribution. So once this has been done, so we now go and cover the most essential parts of her body, such as head. Good. How long was that little stay? I guess just a few seconds. Still. Beautiful. This is what we call a dead still. I would rather teach a very short one, but clean one, rather than just trying to catch the puppy and just, you know, get hold of the pup and sort of force them to do it. Right, the ears. Lovely. Well, it goes without saying that you will be inspecting those quite often when the puppy goes running in the field. Good. Or playing with other pups. Beautiful. Bettie is doing really well. This is what we've been doing for the last couple of days. So those couple of hundred rewards she gets every single meal now have been applied for just allowing me to touch her. So, face. Still. Oh, how gorgeous is that? I really enjoy that. You know, when they start playing along, it becomes such a nice and easy game. Right. Now we will try and inspect Bettie's eyes. Looking right inside those, pulling the eyelids up and down. So having the full good look into it. Right. And the mouth. How about pulling the lips back? Beautiful. Even if little Bettie is never going to become a show dog, and she's not. She's a labradoodle, apparently. She's becoming more and more curly as she is growing up. So she will still have to demonstrate the Bettie. Now you could see her getting either a little uncomfortable or just simply having enough, you know, patience. Oh, it's not something that I come with. Right, so teeth, still beautiful. And one more. Good little Bettie, wait. Again, steady. Well, good. Let's put the food over here. Sit. And still. Bettie, still. Yeah, right. That's not going to go far. And sit. Yes, it will. We'll have to settle for it. I try not to teach two or three things simultaneously. Beautiful display of her bite. Right. And building this up, we will go to different parts of her body. First of all, holding a paw. Not holding in a way that she can't pull out, but again, holding, giving her the opportunity to keep the paw there fairly still. That's a good girl. Good. Now getting into a little stand. Good. Bettie. What I like the most, how focused and not tired she is when doing all those things. Sometimes the session goes into, you know, a good 10-15 minutes. Well, I try not to keep them that long. But she's still responding beautifully. Lift, down, release, reward. So remember, this is always the same sequence. The exercises are not as long, but they're quite demanding. Allowing the dog to go through one behavior, from one behavior to the other. So I try to keep the level of each of those things quite simple. So rub around her body, reward. Right. And to finish this, we will be manipulating the head from left to right. Oh, that was gorgeous, Betty. Good. And from up and down. Good. Nice. A little clockwise turn. Beautiful. The compliance is something that I want every dog to learn from this early age. That way they won't mind if you're taking something out of their mouth, clipping their nails, or grabbing their collar when you want to put them on the lead. I want them to feel very comfortable being handled. This is the basics of all the husbandry that one dog is likely to learn. Stay still. Counterclockwise turn. Good girl. Nice. How about a lift? Laps. Down. Release. Reward. So remember the main rule. It always stays the same. Of course, practicing on my own, I would go through each behavior several times rather than just once or twice as per this video. So, and now little Bettie is doing, well, basically really, really well. So half of the carton is added to that food. We might still go through it, as you can imagine. You can just as comfortably feed the wet food. Hey, Bettie? Yes, I know, she loves it. Steady, steady. Oh, I like that. So, yes, some people just choose not to feed meat by hand. Well, anyway, I don't have any problem with it. So again, it's just a bit messy, but it works the exact same manner. Stay still, Bettie. Still. Gorgeous. There's a little bit there. And there we go. So as you can see, with a spoonful of sugar, makes the medicine go down quite nicely and easily. Little Bettie is a star, and patience is the rule of this game. Thank you very much.